Greetings, this is Charles Darwin talking to you again from the same weedy field turning into a secondary forest that I was at before. And look at the forest that this will eventually turn into. Actually, these are mostly elm trees and sugarberry trees, etc., that are part of a secondary forest. The primary forest, that is with the trees that would be permanent, would include the post oaks mostly, but I don't see any of those here. So this is a secondary forest right here. Look at the lush undergrowth. That lush undergrowth is mostly poison ivy. But anyway, so these are lofty plants. But I'm going to show you something that is not nearly as lofty of a plant. As a matter of fact, it's one of the lowliest life forms that you can see. And that's right here. What is this stuff? It looks like some kind of animal got sick from one end of its alimentary canal or the other and left the evidence on the ground. As a matter of fact, through thousands of years of human history, people have seen this and not known what it was. One of the things they said is that when comets or asteroids went by, or stars as they call them, that this was star snot. And anyway, but I'll tell you what it is. Actually, this is cyanobacteria. This is a mat of cyanobacteria that is growing on a bare space on the ground. Now, it has to be on a bare space on the ground because it's so small, it does not have any leaves, it doesn't have any roots, it can't hold itself up into the sun, so that even small plants like these grasses would be able to shade it out. But when it's out in the open, it has all of the sunlight to itself without having to grow up toward the sun, without having to compete with the other plants. Now, these are cyanobacteria, and therefore, they are not even eukaryotic. They're not even like green algae. Instead, they are cyanobacteria, which means that their chlorophyll has a bluish color mixed in with it, and so this looks almost black, but it's actually a dark bluish green. And so this plant is able to survive on bare spaces in dry areas, and when it's wet, it swells up and turns almost green. That's kind of a dark green. And then right here, it's starting to dry up, and then when it gets really dry, it'll form this kind of crust that could crinkle up and blow away in the wind. But meanwhile, what it's doing is it's growing on the soil and it's just looking out for its own survival. But that's not the only thing that happens. Some of these bacteria are able to fix nitrogen from the air and make it into nitrate, or make it into ammonia, and then other bacteria can make it into nitrate. And so this crust is enriching the soil. Now, that's not what it's trying to do. It's not trying to make the world better for other species, but inevitably some of the ammonium will wash out, will leach out of this, and it will contribute to the growth of the other organisms. And so, in case you've never seen this, or you saw it and you didn't pay any attention to it, now you know what it is. This is Charles Darwin. Tally-ho, and amen.